DT.
It's a wow moment. You know, well, I got a secret to tell y'all. Before anybody knew who Monique was, before anybody was standing to their feet, before anyone was screaming my name, there was this community of people I met when I was 17 years old. And I went to this place in New York called the Garage. Yes. And they welcomed me in such a way that was so loving, so genuine, and so sincere. And I didn't feel like I was this fat black girl that people were pointing to or laughing at. When I walked into that world, it was with open arms. And it was so accepting and so loving. And then I got introduced to something else. I had a cousin say to me, and this cousin, we knew as a child that he was gay. You could see it, you could smell it. He spoke it, honey, he plucked and plucked. At 4 years old, I ain't playing. We were like, oh my God. But I watched, even as that child, how our family treated him. I watched them shun him. I watched when he came around. I heard them say, here come that little fag. I watched them mistreat him. And one night he said to me, when we were adults, he said, I gotta tell you something. I said, what? He said, the boys love me and I love the boys. That's what I said. And he's here tonight. Why I was being introduced to that world. I could not understand why, because I said, well, I'm not a lesbian. Why am I being introduced to this world? I'm not a gay man. Why do I keep being introduced to this world? And then my very best friend since the sixth grade. And I knew in the sixth grade, I'm like, she different. She different. But I watched my very best friend struggle through life, unsure, scared, wouldn't say nothing, not even to me, until the night before my wedding. We were having a conversation and it got so deep, and she was so adamant about homosexuality and how it was against God and the Bible. And at that moment, I looked at her eye to eye, and I said to myself, okay, she didn't have a little cat, and she don't know how to say it to me. And last year, we went on a vacation to a resort. And when she came all the way out, I applauded her because I said, now the freedom begins. Yeah. So, to give me an award this evening for loving is a little confusing for me, because I feel like I should be giving each one of you in here tonight this same award. For loving me, no one else loves. So to all of my gays, all of my lesbians, all of my bisexuals, my transgenders, I say I love you so completely, with no judgment, and please hold your head high, with no apology, because God made you just the way you are supposed to. So I say, let's get back to love.
Hi, you guys. We're back again at DCB. My name is Jordan Moore, David Magazine. I'm here with the lovely Holly Perver, a good friend of mine, and...
You didn't say beautiful.
Beautiful coffee.
Thank you.
And Diva Delicious right here. Just check it out.
Hello! I have to keep my hand on my arm so you don't see my fat arm.
Oh, you did an awesome job tonight, by the way. I know it was kind of hard trying to pull teeth out there, but you did an awesome job.
You know, it's a bad economy, and so I just wanted to try and get as much money from everybody as I could.
You did a great job. Thank you for no more jokes, by the way. In case you weren't here, but you guys missed it, Holly did some great jokes.
Good, bad jokes. It's pain to make people pay.
So what brings you here tonight, besides the auction?
You know what? First of all, I think the Human Rights Campaign is doing so many great things. And I'm going to tell you, my best friends are gay, lesbians, and I... You know what, and Monique said something tonight that really hit home, and Lee Daniels, it's that, you know what, nobody needs to be judged, and my friends are my friends, and if anybody, I'm fiercely protective of them, so anybody who is doing anything to say, you know what, I mean, we're human beings, can't we just treat each other like human beings, and so for me, it's so important to be here, and I met some wonderful people tonight, just further evidence to show me that people with big hearts, people the conscience, people who care, the people that I want to be associated with, that I want to be around personally.
And thank you so much for everything you've done for the community. We all appreciate you. Holly's got my back, by the way, just for the record.
And I'm trying to get more money out of everyone to support it, so watch me. Watch out for me.
Awesome. Thank you so much, by the way. I love you.
I miss you. Me too, I know. Love him.
Once again, it's Torrance with DTV and David Magazine. Thank you guys for tonight. What a great, great time. Hope you all enjoyed everything. It was a great evening, a wonderful experience at HRC 2011.
Well, that will wrap it up for the 24th Annual Human Rights Campaign Gala Dinner and Auction. Stay tuned for what's next on DTV.
Coming up on the next installment of DTV, David Magazine and Chris Coleman Enterprises presents the Sabbath Sunday Swimwear Fashion Showcase.
DTV.
Hey guys, turn again. DTV, David Magazine, David Emotion. We're actually late this morning. Things never stop in our world. We've been here since 3 o'clock in the morning, and now we're actually getting ready to get the model spray tan. So keep looking, take a close look. It's going to be an interesting day. This is the day before the fashion show. Tomorrow's our swimwear fashion show. It's going to be with Andrew Christian and Frank Danny. So come watch.
You're watching DTV, David Magazine in Motion.
DTV. Get ready for the second installment of DTV. From behind the scenes to showtime of Sabbath Sunday's Fashion Showcase. DTV. To find out dates and times for broadcast, join us on Facebook. Search Gaylight TV Atlanta. DTV. And always go to gaylifetv.info to watch Gaylight TV.
Hey, this is Bill, and you're watching DTV.
You're watching DTV, David Magazine in Motion.
Welcome to the dawn.